Hey guys, welcome to my channel Crazy Tech Geek. Today we're going to be unboxing the Nokia True Wireless Earbuds T3010. These are the contents of the box. Flipping to the other side, we get to see the features of the earbuds themselves. 10 hours of playback time, 2 hours to fully charge it, IPX3 rated and 6mm graphene drivers. The cost of the earbuds themselves are quoted at 2000 rupees, but I got my hands on these for 1500 rupees via Flipkart. Opening the box, we get to look at the contents. These are the extra ear tips provided to fit each and every ear shape and size. These are the small and large ones. The medium ones are already fitted onto the earbuds themselves. Next up, we got some paperwork, a USB-A to Type-C cable for charging it. It's a rather small one, actually. Now we get to the case. The case is made of a soft touch plastic. It is cheap plastic, of course. At this sort of price point, you can't expect premium materials. The hinge is quite sturdy actually, and it is magnetic in fact. Coming to the earbuds, they come in a two-tone black and white color. It is a matte finish. The case is very light, compact, and can fit into any pocket. First impressions on wearing these earbuds, they felt really, really lightweight and comfortable to wear for hours together. The bass was really good when I was listening to music. When it comes to controls, we have a physical button to press over here. Play or pause music by single tap. Double tap on the right earbud to skip to the next track and double tap on the left earbud to skip to the previous track. Long press on the right earbud to increase the volume and long press on the left one to decrease the volume. When it comes to the Bluetooth range, I could easily go 2 to 3 rooms away from the phone while the Bluetooth connection stayed strong without disconnecting, so that's a good sign. So I'm going to be talking about the battery life on the Nokia T3010 earbuds. These can be used continuously for about 2 hours when the battery runs out on the earbuds themselves. When you put them back into the case, it gets recharged back up to 100%. And then you use it again. You can repeat this whole process for about 5 times, which puts the battery life of these at about 10 hours, which is not bad considering the price point, but when they are compared to the Nokia Power Earbuds Lite, which I reviewed earlier, a card will be up here or here. Those had an amazing battery life of about 35 hours, so that was really good. When it comes to audio quality, the sound quality was really good. I would not say that they were on par with the Nokia Power Earbuds Lite, but they were decent enough. The bass was really good, but it did not give as much of a thump that the Nokia Power Earbuds Lite gave. For the price, it was decent. When it comes to comfort, I could easily use them for the time that they would run, like for 2 hours without any problems whatsoever, without any ear fatigue, so that's a great sign as well. When it came to call quality, on the other hand, the other party never complained of any audio issues from my side, but when it comes to the audio quality from their end, whenever I wore these earbuds, I heard a lot of disturbances, like the microphones used to pick up a lot of noise from their side. I don't know how this works, but this was one observation that I made. So that's it for this video, guys. I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, then make sure to smash that like button. Let's go for 10 likes. Also, share this video and subscribe to my channel if you're new around here. Take care, guys. Stay home, stay safe, and peace.